easily the most critical information that the ECU relies on is the information relating to engine speed and engine position. Now, engine speed might be pretty self-explanatory, but engine position means that the ECU needs to know which cylinder is firing at any particular time. The reason this information is so critical is that all of the ECU's calculations around fuel quantity and ignition timing are based on engine speed and position data being accurate. Anytime this data isn't accurate could mean that the ECU fires the ignition event at the wrong time in the engine cycle, and particularly on a high performance engine, this can end up giving catastrophic results. Now, in some factory engines, the factory trigger system is absolutely fine on a stock engine, but once we switch to an aftermarket ECU and start modifying the engine, it can be problematic. One of the most common engines that we find these problems with is the Nissan RB26. In stock form, the RB engine is fitted with an optical pickup on the front of the exhaust cam. This provides both engine speed and position information. It has two trigger inputs inside of that optical sensor. There's a 360 degree optical slot which provides the engine speed information, and then there are a series of other slots with a separate pickup which tell the ECU which cylinder is firing at any time. Now, as I mentioned, in stock form this system works well with the factory ECU, but unfortunately with an aftermarket ECU, and particularly once we fit a set of larger cams and heavier valve springs, we can end up with whip and harmonics occurring in the cam belt, which are then transferred into that trigger disc. In turn, this can end up with inaccurate information reaching the ECU. The common solution with the RB engine is to switch from that factory 360 degree optical trigger to a crank trigger system. So what this does is it goes to a trigger disc which is fitted directly to the front of the crankshaft, which gives the ECU engine speed information. Because this is coming directly from the crankshaft, it's guaranteed to be accurate. Now, that information on its own is not enough, because the ECU can't tell from the crank trigger which cylinder is firing at any particular time, particularly because there are two full revolutions of the crankshaft in one engine cycle. What this means is that the ECU also needs one piece of information called a synchronization input, which occurs at half of crankshaft speed, or in other words, once per engine cycle. Well, fortunately, the camshafts turn at exactly half of engine speed, so by fitting a single input to the front of one of the camshafts, this can be used for the synchronization input, telling the ECU where it is in the engine cycle relative to top dead center on number one cylinder on the compression stroke. This gets rid of any potential for trigger issues and gives a rock solid signal that the ECU can rely on, meaning that our ignition timing and our fuel delivery are also rock solid.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.